Hey there, I'm Nicole. I am a writer and story nerd. Welcome back to my Authortube channel. If you are new here, this is going to be more of a talkity thing, so I really suggest, unless you're real super interested in writing slumps due to moving during the pandemic, you check out some of my other videos that are linked below about story structure and writing in general, more specifically. That being said, let's get to it. So basically, I'm gonna chat very briefly, first of all, about kind of what the past week or so has been like in general and for writing, and just specifically like how disruptions to routines screw me and probably everybody else up, unless I'm just like a little 8-month-old baby and I'm like, if you don't feed me at 8 a.m., I'm gonna get really mad. It's basically what this is. So yeah, I have done my master's in the States. I am a dual citizen of both Canada and America, and I've been in Canada since March 13th when the pandemic started. I got a ride home from someone also who is Canadian, who was crossing the border. The three Canadians in our class all like packed a suitcase and went home, not expecting the pandemic and the border to be affected this long. We kind of thought everything would be better. I thought end of May, which was our kind of program finish graduation date. It was like, definitely end of May, we're gonna be good. And we weren't. We were actually probably at one of our worst points, at least up in Canada in May. So yeah. So it is now August, and I finally, a friend of mine goes to the University of Florida, and they were driving down. It's actually a friend's brother. It was driving down in mid-August, and so I said, can I catch a ride to the place where I'm going, to the place where my master's is, and they said yes. So I decided that I would come down. It is very strange. First of all, that person was not an American citizen, and they had just gotten a new passport, so they didn't actually have, you're supposed to have like an I-94 or something, I guess, a little white card in your passport that shows you have a visa. He had a visa, he just didn't have like a little entry visa, I guess it was. So we got pulled over, and so we had to like leave the little toll booth. The border guard was not a happy fellow. If he was a dwarf, I would say maybe he would be grumpy for Halloween, if that was his costume. And he sent us over to the side, and there were a ton of cars waiting at the side. Like, pretty much everybody who came to the border was being sent like to be double checked. Then we sat in our car for about 20-30 minutes, and finally someone came out and they explained, like, you need an I-94, and we were like, okay, like, he didn't know what that was, and I kept trying to answer questions, and they were like, you're American, don't answer this, we don't care, and I was like, okay, sure. So then finally they told us to go into the building, like the border building, so we did, and that was very freaky. We're like in this border building in our masks. There's news of like the weather in Florida playing, which is so random because we were obviously not crossing the border in Florida because it clearly does not border with Canada anyways. And there's one of these signs that's like telling people to report assault in detention. And I was like, oh my God, like there's detention on the other side. Like, is this a detention center? Are we going to jail? Like, what is happening? And then they were very nice and they were just like, here you go. We printed off your little piece of paper, and he gave it to my friend, and we got back in the car and we drove on through. So anyways, it feels very abrupt. I had a routine at home, pandemic routine, you know, work from home. I was in a groove. I had my writing groove. The book was going pretty well. I was ahead on my word count for a little bit. I was at like, right now I'm at 17,000 words, and I haven't written for the past 5 days. So I am no longer ahead of my word count. I am probably not going to reach 40,000 words because we're way past halfway through August and I am not halfway to my goal yet. And I just don't feel like writing, and I'm gonna try to make myself write because I think that would be good, but it's so it feels so abrupt to just be in a rhythm and then suddenly to like go and then be dropped back into here where I'm learning what the laws are where I am now and what we have to do and meeting new people and, you know, getting groceries and stuff delivered and figuring out like what I had to do in terms of like travelers coming in. I've found this too, like any time my routine's been disrupted. NaNoWriMo last year, I went home for Thanksgiving, and I had a job interview the Monday, Tuesday, and then we went home for Thanksgiving on the Friday, and then Thanksgiving was the following Thursday. So it was like the third week of NaNoWriMo, I had a job interview in Chicago, so I got a plane from where I am now to Chicago, and I did the job interview, and like, I'm just in a hotel room, like not doing anything, just enjoying like the luxurious bathrobes, which were amazing, and I did not write at all, and I didn't write at all. I might have written like one or two days that week, and then I went home for Thanksgiving, and so it's so strange, but I feel like the transition of stuff for me, I haven't gotten to, like it just disrupts my routine so much, and I think it just puts my brain in like a different mode that it makes it really, really hard to settle down to write. Like all I kind of want to do is just like lie down and like take another nap. And this is, it's like that anytime my routine kind of changes. It's even more stressful now, I think, when you're like crossing the border and now your family is on the other side of the border and like, I don't know when I'm going back or how long I'm staying. I haven't really worked any of that out yet. It's just a bit of a shock to the system, and it's a bit hard to get out of this writing slump that changing my routine has created. There is no more, I just put up a video of like morning routine, and there's no more like nice, like pretty view on the deck with the dog. There's now my housemate's cat, and we do have a deck outside that I might go try and sit on and like enjoy. And so it's an interesting question of like, do I try to force myself to do it? Do I just say, okay, I can write like, try to write 500 words and go for it? Do I just say, we're gonna give up on it and do the stuff that I do feel like I have energy to do, which is make YouTube videos and that kind of thing? And I would really love to hear from you. Like when you have a change in routine, how do you make sure that you keep writing? If you're in a writing slump, like how do you get out of it? At what point do you like accept, okay, I just really don't feel like doing this, so I'm not going to, or do you try to push through no matter what? I would love to hear about your experience with those changes in routines, how it affects your writing, how you get yourself out of writing slumps. So, hopefully my next video will be how I got out of my big writing slump. Fingers crossed, right? Thank you so much for watching. Let's chat in the comments, and I will see you next time.